come in. Good morning. Welcome, everybody, to another happy Saturday.
It is indeed. I hope you're enjoying the holidays.
I hope you had a great holiday last week. If you're back to whatever you do already.
That's it. That's it. And I tell you what we've got on today.
Please do.
Well, we check out some ice dancing. Also, a boy with a passion for opera.
Yeah.
And Tim's off playing basketball with the Sydney Kings. Let's see how he does.
Lucky boy.
Welcome back. Well, we've got a whole day ahead of us, Shelley. What are we going to do first?
Well, of course, the best way to kick off a Saturday is to start with the Little Mermaid, don't you think?
You're a smart girl.
Here she is.
What's going to happen on The Little Mermaid? Well, you'll just have to wait and see. Patience is a virtue, they say. Have you heard that one? Okay, we'll see you after the break.
You know, I think I've decided that there is nothing better on a Saturday morning than just lazing around watching cartoons.
Oh, but there is.
What?
Are you up for a game of basketball?
Always. And are you up for the Little Mermaid? Here she is. Come on.
Nice work.
Yeah.
But, Shell, you're dribbling.
Oh. I thought you wouldn't get it.
I got it. I'm with you on this one. We'll be back.
Melted butter always does that. Be careful, don't burn yourself.
All right.
Today we are cooking currant slice, so of course what we are going to need is currants.
Very smart, and some brown sugar.
Exactly. Firstly, what we have to do is mix those in a saucepan with the melted butter. Thank you, Melanie.
So, that's all right.
There you go. What we're going to do is mix that all together. Then we're going to put it in a bowl and mix it with one beaten egg and some self-raising flour. Simple. So once you have done your little experiment over there, being very careful, I'll put these in the bowl here.
Oh.
Now, currant slice is great energy food, I've decided.
Really?
Yes, and good basketball food. Oh. That's it. We were just playing and it made us hungry, so I guess this will make us not so hungry. And
I'm always hungry. Basketball or no basketball. That looks good already.
Absolutely. All right, we'll stick it in here then. Mm-hmm. And maybe we can take it out to Tim and the Kings later. There we go.
Whoops.
Yeah.
Oh, there we go. So we mix all the ingredients together, Shell.
Yeah.
And then once we've mixed all of this in, what happens then?
All you have to do is get yourself a baking tin.
Should we have buttered the tin?
Well, if it's a sticky tin.
Right.
Yeah.
And
get yourself a non-stick. You don't have to.
Okay, and you get Mum and Dad to help you put it in the oven.
Can I have a mix?
Of course you can. Thanks. I'm having all the fun.
Well, what do? We put it in the tin. We get Mum and Dad to help us put it in the oven.
Mm-hmm.
We bake it for 20 minutes.
20 minutes? Don't ask me, I'm hopeless in the kitchen. But all I know is that after you've done all of that, it looks like...
Currant slice.
How good is that?
I don't know, let's try it.
Bon appetit. Oh, it's good.
That is good.
It is good.
That's a success! Yes! Yes! Excellent.
Well, let's hope they also have some success on The Little Mermaid. I
got a question for you.
Mm-hmm.
We're going to be through this very soon. How long do you think that other batch is going to take?
Good question. Not too long. Mm. But in the meantime, this is energy food for us, so we should hit the basketball court once more. Rematch. I demand a rematch.
I'm there.
Okay.
Come on. Let's
Good.
Go.
Oh. Didn't work.
Okay, my go. Please don't go in. Please don't go in. Please.
Oh, what a shame. You might have to eat some more energy food.
One. You have a try. We're going to keep going. Until we actually get one in. Why don't you go to Doug? Limited Corporation. Gee, should I have another try?
I know how you're feeling.
There's a lesson in that for everybody.
What's that?
Cook and eat as much nice slice as quickly as you can because you'll get full soon.
Don't you learn anything?
Oh, no
didn't improve my basketball game.
No. Well, maybe you can be taught a few lessons on ice dancing after the break.
Maybe.
Thank you, Kelly.
I do ice dancing. Ice dancing is dancing on the ice with a partner, and my partner is my brother Owen. I've been ice dancing for just under a year, although I've been skating for about 6 years. I train 4 hours a week, early on Monday mornings and on Friday nights. It takes a lot of practice to get better.
Eyes up and stretch those legs more. Make sure you're counting so the foot's coming through the same time.
There are several steps to learning a dance. First, you must learn the individual moves and practice them, and then you put all the moves together to form a dance. My ambition in ice dancing is to get to the nationals and gain a high place in the short term. I love ice dancing because it's a great feeling when I get everything right.
I'm constantly amazed about ice skating. I mean, there's so many different types. We can get on the ice and sort of shuffle around a bit, but there's precision and
pairs.
Ice dancing and pairs and figure skating.
That's right, but I think they should make the shuffle part of the national curriculum.
Hey, yeah.
Yeah.
Why not?
Anyway, if you have something interesting you would like to write and tell us about, this is the address to write to. It is Saturday Disney, P.O. Box 1071, Eastwood, New South Wales 2122.
And don't forget to put your name, age, address and telephone number on the back so we know where we can find you.
That's right. And what can we find right now?
Doug, of course. Here he is.
There.
Somewhere between under the sea and hanging out with Doug.
Exactly. That's where we're going.
What do you mean that's where we're going?
Well, you see, I figure every week we get to do things like go under the sea with the Little Mermaid, we get to hang out with Doug, go to Agrabah and 100 Acre Woods.
Yeah.
But why can't we go somewhere in between on an adventure? So if you could go anywhere, where would you go?
Well, I tell you what, I enjoyed NASA. You know I went to NASA, right?
Fantastic.
But NASA was... NASA! I've got an idea.
Okay. What's your idea, Shel?
Alfoil. Right? Alfoil.
Of course.
You know, we can make spacesuits. Like NASA, because they invented foil.
Oh,
right. So obviously it's space something, and maybe make some outfits.
I'm with you, my friend. I think it's a great idea, but we'll need to work on it during the break.
Silver is your colour. More about this whole intergalactic travel thing that Mel's wanting to do, which sounds like a pretty good idea, and I have a theory about bugs. Today's Diz News is all about bugs, which doesn't really explain my theory about them at all, but I'll tell you afterwards. There are more insects and spiders than any other class of animal. In fact, there are at least 200 million insects for every human, the commonest ones being ants, fleas and flies. Now, insects wear their bones on the outside of their bodies, and you'll find them everywhere, from the Arctic Circle to the Sahara Desert. Jiminy Cricket is one of Disney's best-loved animated characters. In fact, Jiminy was so popular that he went on to appear in several other short and feature-length cartoons, and even hosted his own TV show. Crickets are famous for the noise they make. They do it to attract females and to warn off other males. It's made by rubbing together special combs at the base of their wings, and other crickets hear it through ears that are located on their knees. Insects are incredible. They can do things you'd normally expect from a superhero.
Let's look at these guys, ants. If us humans had the same strength as ants, we would be able to lift 3 cars up above our heads. Now that's tough. Stick insects are the longest insects in the world, and their special talent is disguise. Cockroaches have super senses. Their long, sensitive antenna can detect a movement on the ground of up to 1/1,000,000 of a millimeter. Whereas locusts eat their own weight in leaves every 24 hours. But insects aren't just there to look at. Timon and Pumbaa from The Lion King find that when the going gets tough, a handful of juicy bugs can make a surprisingly tasty snack. And as Simba discovers, they really are quite delicious. See? Bugs are not from this planet. And that is my theory, that bugs actually come from another planet. So why don't Mel and I try and track down where in the galaxy that might be? Weird thought, but I think it's leading somewhere. Why don't you guys get back to Doug?
An ant wrapped in alfoil is a good start to our intergalactic adventure.
Did you not see my Disney's The Bugs thing? Like, these guys can lift the weight of 3 cars above their heads if they're our size, and him being that size, he could probably lift you above his head, so I wouldn't cook him if I were you.
Cook him? I'm not going to cook him.
This is part of my theory. This is all part of the space travel.
You got a space theory?
I do.
I've got a space theory.
You do?
Mm-hmm.
Uh-huh.
We'll tell you about it after the break and after this opera story.
Ew, I don't think you taste very good.
Yeah.
The place is a landmark for Australia's busiest city. Its architectural design is famous the world over, and many Australian and international artists have given all they've got under its roof. Where else could it be but the Sydney Opera House? And what would it be without opera? Many people have had the chance to visit the Opera House, but Pascal, you can tell us what it's like to actually perform here.
It's amazing, basically. It's like nothing you can imagine. Just the thrill of having a crowd and being on stage and it being you.
Who are you at the moment?
I'm a midshipman on a man of war in 1767. I change through the opera. I'm also a powder monkey and a cabin boy.
And the name of the opera you're working on at the moment is?
Is Billy Budd.
Billy Budd, King of the Birds.
I know previously in other operas you've had principal roles. How does it compare being in the chorus?
It's very, very different. A principal role, it's sort of, you really have the spotlight and you can play with it. And whereas in a chorus, you've got to try and fit in with the others. But it's actually just as much fun to be part of a group and performing together rather than performing with yourself.
How did you come to be on the stage?
I sang at a Christmas concert when I was 3. And people saw me there and they said, oh, you know, we should have a look at this boy. And so I got another solo and then I started singing here, the Opera House. And from then on, I've never really stopped. People have just keep on coming up to me saying, you know, can we have you sing here and will you do this for us? And so it's just been amazing amount of fun. So.
Wow, it started when you were 3 and just took off from there.
Yeah, basically.
My compliments to Mr. Redfern and Mr. Flint. And will they take a glass of wine with me?
How do you fit in schoolwork and opera performances and rehearsals?
It's very difficult because I'll go away for the morning and then I come back for the afternoon session at school, and so I have to catch up on the work that they did through the day. And luckily I don't have rehearsals every day. I mean I might have them 4 days a week, and so I've got 1 day to catch up and sort of what they did in the week. And but it's very, very hard.
Mr. Redfern and Mr. Flynn, sir.
You sound very busy, and I know they're wanting you for a rehearsal at the moment, so I won't keep you any longer. I don't want to get you in trouble. But thank you very much for being on Saturday Disney, and good luck with Billy Budd.
Thank you very much.
Do they say break a leg in opera?
Oh, no, that's bad luck.
Oh, you say, well, I won't say that then.
Toy, toy, toy.
Toy, toy, toy. Shh, the show's about to start.
They killed their king.
Aye.
They killed their king and they'll kill ours.
Aye, aye.
Toy, toy, toy. That's one I haven't heard before.
It's a bit of a tongue twister, that one.
Toy, toy, toy. Maybe, toy, they, toy. Maybe they sing it, so it's not such a tongue twister after all.
Maybe. Do you want to have a go?
No. Tell me about your plan.
All right. Well, you know how we wrap our lunch in this kind of stuff?
Yes. Mm-hmm. It keeps it fresh.
Indeed. It protects it. So my theory is simple.
Yes.
It is protection. If we're going to go...
So you think if we wrap ourselves in foil, we'll be protected for space travel?
Absolutely. You'll see, it'll work.
Okay, I think we should go to a break. This process could take some time.
It certainly could.
How? You know, Mel, I'm feeling protected already.
Well, you know, I think you've taken it a little bit too far. You see, I'm talking about protection like this, right?
Ha! Ha!
From lasers, you know. But I don't see how your ponytails need protecting and neither do your jeans.
But it's a fashion statement. I've got a theory for you, though.
Yes?
Like, my theory was that insects are actually from another planet, right? So these guys don't have lasers. And they don't have anything else that's going to zap us that we need to protect us.
That's right. Thanks, Posty.
And you know what? There's something else.
What?
We've designed outfits, but we haven't thought about how we're actually going to get into outer space yet, have we?
Not really, no. But I tell you what, it's easy to get to Aladdin, so how about we go there first?
Maybe Agrabah's a much better idea.
I think so. I'm jealous because you have accessorized too well for my liking.
Thank you, thank you. You know what though, I think we should take our foil and go inside. It's a bit too open out here, people will see us.
Good idea. And also I think that we might bake under the sun. Let's go quick.
Well, you guys have a look at this and we'll reassess our situation.
Something special.
Is it?
The following exciting competition is proudly brought to you by Walt Disney's Mulan. Now available on video.
Walt Disney's animated masterpiece Mulan is an enthralling and fun-filled adventure set against the vast and mysterious landscape of China. High-spirited Mulan defies tradition and disguises herself as a man to take her beloved father's place in the Imperial Army. With her hilarious guardian dragon Mushu by her side, Mulan proves to be a brave and disciplined warrior who brings honor to her family. You can now own your very own copy of Mulan on video. To celebrate, Walt Disney Home Video and Saturday Disney are teaming up to give little Aussie heroes the chance to win a holiday to China. There, they'll visit many of the sites which inspired the Disney animators in their research for Mulan. The search is on for Mulan's Australian family hero, a special child whose extraordinary spirit has brought pride and honour to their family through a simple act of kindness, a bold act of bravery, or a special act of loyalty. You can enter the competition yourself, or have a member of your family or a friend nominate you. Each entry must be accompanied by a letter answering this question: what's the most important thing you've done for your family? The winner of Mulan's Family Hero Search will fly with up to four members of their family for the adventure of a lifetime to China. So send your entry to Mulan's Family Hero Search, P.O. Box 181, South Yarra, Victoria 3141. Entries close on the 8th of May 1999. So good luck!
Hey, Shel. Do you think this is enough protection?
For the minute, anyway, we're going to a break, but after that we're off to the planet of basketball, so maybe we'll need some more.
Uh-huh.
The I've had a challenge letter sent to me this week. Let me catch my breath. It was from Luke, a guy from the Gold Coast. He wanted me to play ball with the big guys. He meant basketball, with the Sydney Kings, of course. So I've come down to the training centre here, and I can't seem to find anyone. I'm gonna go looking. See you later.
Guys, I've been looking for you everywhere. I'm the guy that's gonna challenge you.
Okay. Yeah, yeah, I heard about
Tim,
that.
Tim.
How are you? Darren Smith.
All right.
Brad Rosen, how you going?
Okay, these guys are from the Sydney Kings. Brad, what is your position on the court?
Point guard.
Point guard, and what does the point guard do?
Well, basically the point guard is the one that, if you call it, when we get the ball back from defence, is the one that brings up the ball and calls the plays. He sort of has to know all the plays and all the positions, so if the guys have a bit of trouble, and it's not sort of the leader on the court, but it's the leader with the offence type thing, you know. He's got to make sure that everyone gets into position and waits for everyone in their right positions, and then sort of runs the plays and makes sure everything runs properly.
Darren, what's your position on the court?
I'm an off guard, so I'm still one of the little guys, probably a little bit bigger than a point guard. But my job is to, once the point guard gets the ball, to run hard and try and get easy shots for the team, and also play good defense on the opposition's off guards.
What do you guys do for training?
We train, of course, all over the week and stuff. And,
yeah,
you know, it could be whether we do some weights or whether we do what's called an individual. That's just working out with a coach and taking, you know, a couple hundred jump shots or something like that. Or, of course, on the court with the whole team.
So, in the challenge letter, it said, play ball with the big guys, but I noticed you're not the biggest guy in the world.
Yeah, that's true. That's why I'm standing on this little step here.
Get up there.
But no, I'm actually 5'11", which is the shortest in our team. And there's a few guys a bit bigger than me, like ACL, who's our import here. He's just on 7 foot. So yeah, he's a little bit taller than me. But yeah, he's massive, quite honestly. But for me, 5'11", one of the shorter guys in the league, it's just you know, something that I've just sort of had to grow up with. And people said that I wasn't going to be able to make it. But you know, to everyone out there, you can make it. Doesn't matter how tall you are. So you just you know, you just maybe have to train that little bit harder and have that little bit more fight in you.
Excellent. Inspirational. We should get playing, I guess. Do you guys know any games that we can sort of get into on the court?
Absolutely. Yeah. Let's go inside and try some.
All right. I've eaten this challenge up. I've earned my singlet. Now I'm feeling pretty confident. I might try a bit of a dunk comp. What do you think, Darren?
Let's do it.
Alright.
Check out his hang time.
It's got ups. Didn't think I could do it, did you?
It's impressive stuff.
Thanks, man.
Earn your stripes.
Alright, till next time.
Absolutely.
Okay.
You know, if Tim's gonna take on those guys again, I think we send along our space ball.
Good idea. I don't know quite what they're going to do with it, but nevertheless.
Well, you know, it's going to have some merits. It's spacey. Kind of like your space board.
Space board, space ball.
Never seen one like this in Agrabah.